Hello students, welcome to MJC Learning. Today, in this session, we are going to cover the subtopic types of CSS in the topic Advanced Web Designing. Here, we will be learning about types of CSS, inline CSS, internal or embedded CSS, external CSS, and some sample CSS programs. In the earlier section, we saw an intro to CSS, its properties and its relations with HTML. Now we will see the types of CSS with its formats. So for a flashback, CSS is a style sheet language which is used for formatting an HTML document. Tags were used in HTML, but in CSS, we will be using different types of selectors with properties and values. Properties, two properties are separated with a semicolon, and the property and the value is separated with a colon. All the properties are enclosed in curly braces. This was a flashback of CSS. The types of CSS. In this tutorial, you will learn three types of CSS and the difference between them with programming. So the three types of CSS are inline CSS, internal CSS, and external CSS. The first type is inline CSS. It is useful when we need to define a specific style for individual elements on a web page. For inline CSS, every style content is in HTML elements. It is used for a limited section. It is specific to a tag itself and affects only single elements. This allows CSS properties on a per tag basis. So it uses the HTML style attribute to style a specific tag only. The style attribute can contain any CSS properties between double quotes. It is declared in any tag of the body element. So it is useful if you only want a small amount of markup, but it is not a best practice for a good programmer since the code will be quite large and very complex. Let's take an example here. Body H1 style is equal to, in the double quotes, you enclose all the properties here and close the double quotes. Inline CSS, close H1. So in inline CSS, we are introducing the style attribute. You can use it in any tag with the properties we have already learned. So in inline CSS, all the properties will be enclosed in the style attribute in double quotes. This is an example program of inline CSS. Start with a doc type HTML declaration, the HTML tag, head tag, title is inline CSS, close the head, start with the body. So in the body, we are going to declare all the selectors and styles. So in H1, style is equal to text decoration colon underline, color colon magenta, text align colon center. Inline CSS. So one heading will be given in the beginning of the web page, inline CSS, which will be underlined in the middle of the page and in color magenta. P style is equal to font family. P is for paragraph tag. So whatever is written in the paragraph will be in the font family Jokerman, text align left in the color blue. So this para is in blue color in font Jokerman. Close the paragraph tag, close the body tag, close the HTML tag. So it will show you an output like this. Heading will be in middle of the page, underlined in magenta color, and the paragraph will be in font Jokerman, aligned at the left center in the blue color. This was an example of inline CSS. So inline CSS is enclosed in the body section using the style attribute in a particular tag only. Next is the internal or embedded CSS. It's also called as embedded CSS. Internal style sheet is a set of styles that is created as part of the HTML document. Style rules contained in internal CSS only affect the document in which they reside. It may be used if one single page has a unique style. That is, when you want to apply similar styles to all the elements present on a web page. Internal style sheets are created using the style element added inside the head element of the HTML document. So this style performs an action in the entire HTML body. Let's take an example of internal CSS. Starting with the declaration, right till the head, title. After title, you are not closing the head tag here. Introduce the style tag. The style tag. See, in inline CSS, we have used style as an attribute in a particular tag. Here, we are using the style as a tag, and it is a pad tag, but it is always written in the head section. So here also, I have declared the same properties and the selectors which I have used in the earlier program, but writing way is different. So here, the heading is again in underline magenta color and in the text align center. And P, font family, Jokerman, text align left, color blue. So here you are enclosing all the properties in curly braces with separated with semicolons. So H1 and P are the two things defined in the style attribute. Close the style, close the head. This is only declaration. In the style attribute, we are not going to write any content which will be displayed on the web page. They are only style properties. In the body, you display what is to be displayed as a content on the web page. So H1, internal CSS, close H1. P, this para is in blue color in font Jokerman, close P. So H1 will take all the properties which are defined here. So internal CSS which is written will be in the underline magenta color and center. Somewhat like this. And the paragraph will be in Jokerman font, aligned in the left in the blue color. This is the output of it. So this was the second type. The third type of CSS is external CSS. External style sheet is a separate page which is linked to the HTML page. External style sheets are used whenever we have many HTML attributes and we can use them as required. There is no need to rewrite the CSS styles again and again in a complete body of HTML. You can create a text file which contains all the styles that are to be applied. So one file will be having only styles without any HTML tag. Save the file with extension .css, and then you are adding the links to this external style sheets on any web page in the website. So in the beginning, you have to open Notepad and write only the styles in curly brackets. There should be no doc type declaration, head, title, body tag, style tag, nothing. And save it as .css file. Give a name .css. And then Second document will be HTML document. In that you are going to write the normal program how we write in HTML, and you are going to link this .css file in it. The link element in external CSS is defined in the head section. The link element is to link the .css file to HTML document and is defined in the head section. It is an empty tag. Link tag has no closing tag. So it is declared like this in the head section. This is a piece of programming code. You have head, you can write the title here and then close the title and then start the link tag. Link relation is equal to style sheet. Type is equal to text slash CSS. And href is equal to the name of the file which is to be linked. So these are the three attributes which are in the link tag. And again, link tag is not a paired tag. It's an empty tag. This is a sample program which is demonstrating the external CSS. So you have to open Notepad and create a CSS file here. H1 text decoration underlines in the all three examples, in all three types of CSS, I'm using the same thing. You should only notice how to use these properties in the three styles. I'm writing it differently. Here, one file will have only the properties with the selectors. There is no tag. Just write these two lines and save the file with name.css. So in H1, text decoration colon underline, color magenta, text align center. And P, font family Jokerman, text align left and color blue. These are the two styles defined. Then you open another HTML file, the Notepad++ editor, and start with this program. The declaration first, doctype HTML, head, title. After closing the title, go for the link tag. Link relation is equal to style sheet, type is equal to textless CSS, and href will be the style file, the name of this style file, .css. Close the head. And in the body, you write normal things how we write. Heading will be H1, external CSS. P will be the paragraph in the blue color in font Jokerman. Close P, close body, close HTML. So when I say H1 and P, this is only the text. I have not specified any attributes here which are going to style these two tags. So these are all declared in this style file. And this style file is defining these two selectors with the following properties here. So this was an example. Next, let's see the background color property. The background color will be a background color in the full body of the web page. So here you define the doctype HTML. HTML head title. We are learning the background property using HTML CSS. Close head, and this is the internal style I've used. You can use any of the three styles for defining. I'll just show you this property how it works. So in the style body, background color colon yellow. So the yellow background will be in the full body of the web page, and I have written two headings here in the H1 and H2 format respectively. One with a color colon blue. This is the first property. Semicolon, border colon dashed. Dashed border will be given as the outline. Text align will be center, and margin top will be 60 pixels. Margin will start 60 pixels from top. And in the H2, there will be a letter spacing between the letters as 30 pixels. Text align center and margin top 50 pixels. Three things are defined here. Close the style, close the head, start with the body. So in the H1, I have written this text is blue and dash border. So whatever is written in the H1 will inherit the properties from here. Body will take the background color as yellow. And H2, letter spacing 30 pixels. This will be written with 30 pixel letter spacing, aligned in the center, and margin top 50 pixels. Close body, close HTML. This is the output of it. Say the background color is yellow. The H1 is written in blue color. This is the dashed border format with a margin top 60 pixels. Otherwise, the text starts from here, right in the beginning. I have given some spacing here, top margin. So this heading is written slightly below the margin starting. Again, it will leave some space because again, top part I have written 50 pixels for H2 also. So the letter spacing, see the spacing, it looks spatial. So this letter spacing is 30 pixels and aligned in the center. Next is the background image property. Earlier was a background color. Now we will see how to put a background image. See the output? There's an image in the background and some text is written in front of it. So in the head section, again, the style attribute, you have to put body background image property. Hyphen will be, there should be no space in the middle anywhere when you are writing the property. Background hyphen image colon URL round bracket. In the double quotes, you specify the name of the JPG file or the name of the image. Double quotes close, round bracket close, and curly bracket close. URL is the path of the image file here. So this is how you are going to display the property here. And one line I have displayed here, H1 color colon white. Text align center and text decoration underline. Close the style. So there is the body background image and one heading in the beginning. Close the body. The body will inherit the properties from the body selector and H1 tag will take the properties from H1 selector. So whatever is written here, this page is with a background image, will be in white color, in the center, and in underline format. So this was about the background image property. With these three types of CSS, I hope you have understood. So I end up this session here. Try to understand the styles, properties, and programming in CSS. Also try and learn a few programs by yourself, simple outputs of your choice. Use all the three types and write for you to learn and practice. All the best. Thank you.